let us go for the working rule how we are going to solve a question. I am just going to tell you step by step. Now, working rule to prove that the statement is true for all natural numbers and using principle of mathematical induction. Now, given example is Pn is a statement given by square of the n natural numbers, and this is the series, this is the result. Okay. Now, step 1 is a called so called we are calling it as a basic step. Now, step 1, basic step, we have to write all the statements. Okay. We are writing step 1, basic step. Now, in the basic step, we will be writing for n is equal to 1. This is the basic step. Now, P1. Now, 1 I am going to put here, that is 1 square. 1 square is 1. This is equal to 1 upon 6 with 1 n. 1 plus 1 with 2, and twice of 1 plus 1, that is 3. Now, this becomes 6 upon 6 is equal to 1. Therefore, P1 is true. This is the first step which we are going to do it. Now, step 2, that is called inductive step. We will be writing step 2. Inductive step. Or you can write it induction step, one and the same thing. Okay. So, this is for n is equal to k. And after writing this, we are assuming it. We have to write it, assume that when for 1 the statement is true, then we will be assuming. Assume that pk is true. In place of n, if we are putting k, in the induction step, we will be saying it is true. So, this is the step 2. Now, here then step 2, what we can write it? 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square plus k square is equal to 1 upon 6 k with k plus 1 with 2k plus 1. This is the way to for step 2. Now, we are having step 3 for n is equal to k plus 1. Now, step 3 for n is equal to k plus 1. Now, just look here what is written. Using the assumption made in step 2, show that the statement is true for n is equal to k plus 1. Now, how to show it? Because step 3, we are going to write it step 3 in this format, and then what we are writing, we will just look here. To obtain pk plus 1 at k plus 1th term to both sides. Now, k plus 1th term means what? That is, now here it is n square. What will be the next term? In place of n, now we are going to put k plus 1. So, that is k plus 1 whole square. Is it clear? So, now the question will be 1 square plus 2 square plus k square plus k plus 1 whole square, is it clear, is equal to 1 upon 6. Now, in place of n, I am putting k plus 1. Then, sorry, here it is k, then k plus 1, then twice of k plus 1 plus k plus 1 whole square. Now, this side, what this becomes? Now, this side becomes 1 square plus 2 square plus, now the last term is k plus 1 whole square. Okay? Now, you have to solve this part. Now, when we are solving this part, we will be having 1 upon 6 k with k plus 1, 2 k plus 1 plus 6 times k plus 1 whole square. And when you are solving this part, then what we will be having? We will be getting 1 upon 6 with k plus 1, k plus 2, and then we will be having 1. This will be the result. Now, this is the result. Now, what this shows? Here we will be taking right hand side is true for P n when n is equal to k plus 1. Now, what I have written? Just look it. I have written here that right hand side is true for P n when n is equal to k plus 1. What is P n? This is P n. When it is true, when n is k plus 1. Now, look it. In place of this n, do we have k plus 1 whole square? Yes, we are having. In place of this n, do we have k plus 1? Yes. For this n, do we have k plus 2? N means k plus 1. K plus 1 plus 1 becomes k plus 2. And then for 2n plus 1, do we have 2k plus 1 plus 1? Yes, we are having. So, in place of n, we are having, we say that it is true because here n becomes k plus 1. That is what the step 3. Now, just look, using the assumptions made in step 2, show that the statement is true for n is equal to k plus 1, and we have shown that this is true. So, like this, we are going for step by step. Now, we can hear now, next statement will be that P n implies, or we can write it, next statement, let me write it. Now, therefore, PK implies that P K plus 1 is true. Okay, one and the same thing. PK implies that P K plus 1 is true. Therefore, P n is true by the principle of mathematical induction. Now, this completes the principle of mathematical induction.